Good morning. The very long inconsistent judgment in respect of dissolution of marriage, from time to time the Supreme Court varies its ratio. This is one of the case. AIR 2020 Supreme Court 1198. Banumadi J. Abdul Nazir and A.S. Bopanna. Mangayar Karsi vs. M. Yuvaraj case. The facts of the cases was that both the parties loved each other and entered into solemnization of marriage on 8/4/2005. The wife is elder than the husband about 6 to 7 years. They were blessed with a female child, and thereafter there was differences of opinion. The wife seems to be using all sorts of filthy languages in the presence of others, and she went to college where the husband was working, and in the presence of students insulted him, and therefore legal notice was issued, but that was not properly responded. Then husband filed section 13, dissolution of marriage on the ground of cruelty. Wife filed petition section 11 for restitution of conjugal rights. Both were clubbed together, and there was no family court therein. Therefore, both OPs were filed before the trial court, and that was dismissed. Then they went to district court on appeal. That appeal was also dismissed. Then second appeal. Second appeal, High Court has allowed the degree by setting as the lower court judgment on the ground that the marriage was retrievable, and the acquittal of the case based upon the complaint of the wife was considered as one of the ground. So this was the case. The wife has filed a complaint before Negamam police station, and the charge sheet was filed, and subsequently the case was entered on acquittal. The very contention of the Supreme Court was based upon the issues framed by the Second Appeal High Court. Whether the courts, see, this is most important, I am reading it because while preparing second appeal, there should be substantial question of law of general importance, and the matter which was not decided earlier, you kindly go through section 100. They say whether the courts below are correct and justified in failure to dissolve the marriage of the appellant and responded on the ground of mental cruelty for alleged complaint dated 24/11/2007 against the appellant and her in-laws, whether that constitute cruelty. Then same for overlooking the subsequent event regarding the lodge of false complaint. So pending the disposal of the OPs, subsequent event was considered. That was not looked. Then whether honorary acquittal is entitled for decree of the divorce. The court discussed the matter very deeply about so many cases, but finally the Supreme Court has held that the framing of issues is not correct. There was no substantial question of law properly framed. They say since this was not either a defense or facts about the acquittal, therefore the criminal case automatically treating as a ground for divorce will be against the statutory provision. That was the ratio of the Supreme Court. Then they say the mental cruelty allegedly is not that much of serious, and therefore they say the retrieval marriage was not a good ground in the given case to give dissolution of marriage. Then they say Naveen Kohli versus Neelu Kohli cases, Sangamitra Ghosh versus Rajkumar Ghosh, AR 2006. Then Samar Ghosh versus Jaya Ghosh. All these things were retrievable marriage, continuous separation was considered. But in the instant facts, they are thoughtful consideration that we notice the parties hail from conservative background, where the divorce was considered a taboo and further they have female child. Therefore, they have dismissed, they have set aside the judgment of the High Court and allowed the SLP. And if they want, they may file another case on the ground of cruelty and get acquitted. So this is another impact. So we should be very careful in drafting so many things. Sometimes they say irretrievable marriage, breakdown. Now here madam judgment says social background. Then they say acquittal, giving false complaint is a good ground for cruelty. But here they say that was incidental after filing of the case. And particularly framing of substantial question of law was shaken by the Supreme Court, that this framing of substantial question of law was not proper. So this is the way. And what happened after long years, both have not, their tie has not been cut off, but still tie exists and both are living. Let us hope that anything may happen for their reunion. Unfortunately, these sort of cases, what happens, the husband made to suffer for a lot. After dragging a wife to long proceedings of years, up to Supreme Court, how one could expect a reunion with the same wife? So automatically the wives used to nag, even efficiency have been criticized as an incapacitated person. So you are not fit for anything. Then they say you have lost all the cases. Your threatening was waste, continuous, then another harassment would be possible. However, this 142, finality of the judgment is there. The judgment was, by A.S. Bopanna. This is was on 3/3/2020. It's all right. That means just a few weeks before the pandemic quarantine regulations. Then what happens after opening of the court, they may try their best in implementing the case. The several judgments, whether that were overruled or not, has not been stated here. But you kindly see, this judgment is not overruling the so many other judgment, and Naveen Kohli and Sangamitra Ghosh cases are. Naveen Kohli AR 2006 and Sangamitra Ghosh 2007, then again 2007. These cases are there. Probably after long years, family court appeals are not been considered for disposal, and then it will take years together. They just said CMSA So if there is no family court, there is possibility of second appeal, best wishes.